Well, on today's program, I'm pleased to welcome Shannon Perry, who's the general manager of the Ontario Convention Center in sunny California. Hello, Shannon.
Hello, Jeff. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. How are things in your area of the country?
So we're doing pretty well out here, other than what everyone is dealing with the pandemic. Sunny Southern California just got a week full of rain last week, but we're also starting to function as a vaccination distribution center for the state. So that's rolling out today.
Oh, your convention center is busy then?
Yes.
All right. Well, we're going to talk about the convention center there in Ontario. Tell us a little bit about it. Maybe some of the highlights of your facility, how many people can attend.
Absolutely. So we are located, as you mentioned, in sunny Southern California in Ontario. We are about 225,000 square feet of flexible meeting and event space. Our exhibit halls are column free, which is really important if you're doing sporting events for sight lines in there. We are surrounded by obviously lots of hotels and restaurants and two major retail outlets. But we're also, what's really important is we're also located only 2 miles from an international airport, which makes getting here really easy. We're also only about a mile away from the world famous Toyota Arena.
Well, definitely sounds like a nice place to have an event or to attend an event. Let's talk about the GBAC Star Facility Accreditation Program. Sure. Your facility decided to invest in that. What was the trigger? Why did you make that decision?
So while we have always been focused on cleanliness as part of safety and as part of the guest experience, it really was in direct response to this COVID-19 pandemic. While we were already doing the work, this accreditation confirms it and it communicates it to everyone who is coming into the building that we take cleanliness and sanitation very seriously and we take their safety very seriously.
A big picture, what does this mean for your staff and their visitors to your facility?
Sure. So, I mean, as I mentioned, it really is about communication, but it's also about process and making sure we're doing the same things over and over and we're not laxing in any area. So as we open the facility to the general public again to hopefully have lots of new events and rebooked events in the building, we are exceeding the expectations of our guests and of our staff. The safety of our staff and our team members is just as important as any visitors that we have coming into the building. And so we are demonstrating that we are taking every safeguard that we possibly can to keep our guests and our visitors and our staff safe.
Yeah, that communication is important. That peace of mind is what everyone's looking for, not just those that attend your events, but the workers that are there every day as well.
It also encourages our clients to rebook with us and to not have to worry. When you're not worrying about safety or cleanliness or are my visitors going to have a safe time or a good time, then you can focus on having a successful event. And having a successful event is what we all want to be doing right now.
That's right. You know, Shannon, there are 20 elements that are part of the GBAC Star Facility Accreditation Program that everyone has to review and learn and adapt to. Does anything stand out specifically among the 20 that was maybe a little challenging or you had to spend more time on?
Sure. To be honest with you, we had many of the elements already in place, but we weren't looking at them as a comprehensive unit. So the GBAC Star accreditation process helped us create a comprehensive understanding of all of those elements and how they relate to each other. So from the infectious disease protection policies to the reordering policies to staff training and inventory control and inspections. So those were all elements that we may have had in place, but we weren't looking at it as a comprehensive unit. So, and once we see how they interrelate with each other, it clicks in with the staff a little easier and it makes repeating them and repeating those processes easier. So it also, to be honest with you, it also helped create a more stringent like auditing process. So now that we have like a regimented, this is what happens every week, this is what happens every month, every quarter, annually, let's review this. We can make sure that we're up to date on all the current safeguards.
Interesting perspective, appreciate that. I wanna talk about what you have started doing because of GBAC Star accreditation. that might be different from the past and something that you might continue doing in the future? Does anything stand out there?
So it would probably, to be frank with you, we're going to keep all of these things in place even after the pandemic is quote unquote under control. Hopefully as the virus gets under control, everyone is still remaining cognizant of how important keeping a clean and sanitized environment is. We're hoping that that remains in place. But specifically things that were new to us were, like I mentioned, the review process. So that we're constantly reviewing, is this the most current up-to-date policy we could be following? Is this the most current up-to-date chemical we could be using? Have we heard something from the World Health Organization? Have we heard something from our local medical professionals? So we weren't updating it and reviewing it as often as this accreditation process suggests.
Many of these will be top of mind moving forward. A lot of folks are trying to get through the pandemic, but eventually when the pandemic ends, we still have to be ready for anything that could come our way.
That's absolutely true.
Yeah, my last question, Shannon, is about if you're having a conversation with another organization, maybe another general manager of a convention center, and GBAC Star comes up, what would you tell them they should do?
Okay, well, I would definitely recommend that other public use facilities pursue achieving their Star facility accreditation. Ensuring that proper cleaning and the disinfection techniques are in place to keep people safe, that's the responsibility of all of us, period. It's not just about appearance, it's about the health and safety and well-being of everyone.